This video is about a question: is Israel a fake state? I'm asking this question because of a comment made by Kerry Ann Gidden. Kerry Ann Gidden is a YouTuber. She made a video, and on several occasions, she claims, or she has claimed, that Israel is a fake state. She didn't give reason why she thinks Israel is a fake state, and I'm not sure whether it was a vision that was given to her that Israel is a fake state. There's no archaeological evidence to support the claim that Israel is not a state. Israel is mentioned in the Bible. The whole Bible is built on Israel, and Jerusalem is mentioned so many times in the Bible. So I believe that Israel is a state, and is the state mentioned in the Bible. So I disagree with Kerry Ann when she says that Israel is a fake state. There are so many people who have challenged the existence of Israel, from political, ideological, and other grounds. Some of them even challenge the existence of Israel based upon international law. I'm not sure what Kerry Ann saw or what she heard in a vision for her to make a claim that Israel is a fake state. If Kerry Ann is saying that people who live in Israel, they are not genuine Hebrews or Jews, probably she may be right, because it's not everyone who says he or she is a Jew who is actually a Jew. And Jesus himself said it in Revelation chapter 2 verse 9. It's not every Jew who is a Jew. And so it's not everybody who lives in Israel who is a Jew, even though they would claim to be Jews. And that's why Gamal Abdel Nasser, the Egyptian president, found it difficult to negotiate with the government of Israel. His argument is that the rare Jews are driven, or were driven, from Israel, and they are scattered over the world. And Kerry Ann is saying that the children of Israel, the children of Jacob, they are scattered over the world, and she claims that some of them, they live in the United States. And she claims that it was revealed to her that she, Kerry Ann Gidden, is from the tribe of Manasseh. I would not dispute that, because based upon historical records and archaeological records, and also based upon the Bible itself, it is true that there are a lot of black people who are descendants of the true Hebrews, as recorded in the Bible, as supported by historical evidence. And I also want to put on record that I had a dream or a vision that the sons of Jacob are scattered in Africa and other parts of the world, including the United States. So if Kerry Ann is saying that Israel is a fake state because people living there are not true Jews or true Hebrews, then I may agree with her on that point. Kerry Ann also made a comment that an angel of the Lord by name Meleki revealed to her that the Temple of Solomon is found in Zimbabwe. I have difficulty with that, and I will be happy if Kerry Ann Gidden will respond to this video and clear the facts. Number one, why is it that Israel is a fake state? And number two, she should also comment more on the vision she had that she was shown by an angel called Meleki that the Temple of Solomon is found in Zimbabwe. Zimbabwe is a country bordering South Africa. It's in Southern Africa. So this is a very controversial statement, particularly if Kerry Ann says that it was an angel, Meleki, who revealed that mystery to her. I want to make it clear that there are Hebrews who are scattered over the world, and a lot of them are black. They may be in Africa, the Caribbean, or in the United States. That is true. And no fraud, no historical distortion or fake DNA and can refute that divine fact. There are a lot of Hebrews who are black, who are scattered over the world, and historical records have been falsified to deny their Hebrew heritage. I want to make a point. The fact that you are a Hebrew, whether you are black or white, doesn't matter. What matters is whether your name is written in the book of life. Let's look at the book of Daniel, chapter 12, verse 1, where Daniel talks about a trouble that is coming to the world. And at that time, Michael, the angel, will come and deliver all people. And Michael is going to deliver only a small section of people. And who are those? Daniel chapter 12, verse 1, reading. The heading is "The Time of Great Trouble." At that time, thy people shall be delivered, everyone that shall be found written in the book of life. You have to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior for your name to be written in the book of life, so that you will be delivered from the trouble that is coming. That trouble is coming very soon. You must be very skeptical about those who claim to be Jews. They are very happy when somebody tells them they are Jews. They are black, they are Jews, they live in America, they live in Jamaica, they live in Nigeria or any part of the world. They are black, they are Hebrews, and they are happy. The mere fact that you are Hebrew, whether you are black or white, doesn't matter. What matters is if your name is found written in the book. It doesn't matter whether you are a Bantu. In fact, Kerry Ann is saying that an angel revealed to her that she is from the tribe of Manasseh. That doesn't mean anything if your name is not written in the book of life. You will not be delivered at the time of trouble. Paul was saying the other day that There's no difference between a Jew and Gentiles. If you accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior, you'll be saved. You can claim to be a descendant of Abraham. It doesn't matter if you do not accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior. You will not be saved. Your name will not be found written in the book, as prophesied by Daniel in chapter 12 of the book of Daniel, chapter 12, verse 1. And so it doesn't matter if you are from a Bantu tribe, and whether you are from the tribe of Manasseh, whether you are Hebrew. And this is a warning to the so-called Hebrew Israelites. They become a cult, and they falsely believe that they are Hebrews, and therefore they will be saved. If anybody tells you that, the person is leading you to hell. I heard the other day, I read on the YouTube that there are some black Americans, they are transgender, and they are looking for a president who will protect the rights of black transgender people. This is a heathen culture that the so-called children of Jacob have copied in Babylon. You will not be saved because you are part of Babylon. Revelation chapter 18 wants you to come out of Babylon. And coming out of Babylon includes fleeing away from all the heathen practices in Babylon, including homosexuality and the so-called LGBTQPLM nonsense going on in the United States. Don't let anyone take you to hell by telling you that you are a Bantu, you are an African, you are a Hebrew, and that's it. Please, Kerry Ann, explain to them that being Bantus alone would not save them. Being black Hebrews alone would not save them. You have to be point blank and tell them, if you're a prophet, that alone will not save them. Kerry Ann, please respond. Respond to my question. Why is Israel a fake state? Number two, also explain further how the angel Meleki told you that Solomon's temple is in Zimbabwe. We are in the end of days. Matthew chapter 24 verse 4 tells us, let no man or a woman deceive you. Repent and accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior. Subscribe to Messiah Revelation Ministry and help us spread the word of the Lord to all four corners of the world. Thank you.